get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Jody Donovan, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Play as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now here's the star of Match Game PM.
Thank you, Johnny Olson and friends. Got a lot of friends there, John.
And we have lots of friends here. We have our regular friends, Brett Summers.
Hello,
that sweet lady.
Darling.
How are you? And Charles Nelson Reilly,
hi.
Whose work is his life, as he says. And Richard Dawson, what does he always say?
My life is my work.
My life is my work. Now, those are our regulars.
Four.
And our semi-regulars, people who are here as often as we can get them, are this fellow here, Dick Martin, who is 70% of the team of Rowan and Martin.
At least 70%.
And this sweet singing, acting type lady, whom we've never had before, we're delighted to welcome this sweet Jody. You're just too sweet.
Smooth.
Jody Donovan. And that lady there, who's here as often as we can get her.
I'll do it for you.
You do it. Thank you very much. Okay. Fanny Flagg, and now let's say hello to our two players, Gene Harrison and Craig Ahrens. Now, we'd like to find out a little bit about each of you. Let's begin with you, Craig. Tell us a story of your life.
Okay, I live in Huntington Beach. I sell real estate. I enjoy tennis, and I ski.
Really? Where do you ski? In this area?
Well, locally right now, but primarily at Mammoth.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good luck to Craig. Now, this is Gene Harrison.
Hi, Gene.
Hello there, Gene. How are you?
Excited.
Are you excited?
Yes. Yeah.
You have an owl pendant there.
Uh-huh.
Is that a good luck omen, a talisman of good luck?
Yeah, my good luck charm is in the audience.
Who is that?
Right on the front row, that good-looking stud there.
Yes, the good-looking stud there. Yeah. I don't see any horses in the audience, do you? You have a friend.
Uh-huh.
In the first row.
Yeah.
Where are you from, Gene?
Originally from England.
Yes, you live here now?
In Altadena.
In Altadena.
And I'm married and got two little girls, Sharon, 12, and Michelle, who's 3. And I think Match Game is the best program on TV, and I think you're kind of cute.
Aren't you sweet? Oh, you're a sweet lady. The one in the gray suit and the striped tie, is that the one?
White.
Oh, the white shirt and the yellow sweater, that one there, okay.
And two English friends.
And two English friends. Well, they're all rooting for you. May I remind both of you contestants that you're going to be trying to match as many of our celebrities as you can. Now, the winner will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. Now, Craig, we're going to ask you to make your selection here. Do you want A or B?
I'll take B, please.
B it is. We're off and running. Poor Stanley.
Aww.
As he ran down the block with every dog in town chasing him, he said, "That's the last time I'll go to a costume party dressed as a blank." Did you hear all that, Craig? Poor Stanley, as he ran down the block with every dog in town chasing him, he said, "That's the last time I'll go to a costume party dressed as a blank." Do you think about that? And they're writing their answers here. Ready? Okay.
I'm ready.
Right. Okay, here we go. Craig. Poor Stanley. Say, aw. Aw, poor Stanley. As he ran down the block with every dog in town chasing me, he said, "That's the last time I'll go to a costume party dressed as a..."
Fire hydrant.
Fire hydrant is a good answer. Now, having heard the audience response, I tremble to think what will happen to the celebrity who does not say fire hydrant.
Oh.
What do you say?
That was my second choice.
Oh, it was?
Yes. First choice was a little pussy.
Hey! Okay. What do you say? Well, that's one of the logical things. Dogs do chase cats, don't they?
You see my little mouthies?
Yes, I see your mouth. Your mouth is moving and sounds are coming out of it.
No, it's a gape.
It's a gate.
It's a gate.
Here we go.
Because I was so shocked. I was so sure.
Fire hydrant is what he wants.
Well, honey, you fire hydrants don't move. You just kind of go there and lift up your little leg. I said a pussycat.
Oh, well, that's two of those in a row. Now, Charles?
The litter is getting bigger every second.
Oh, it is. So we have three little pussycats, Craig Aarons. Let's see what we've got down here. Jody.
Just adding to the mistakes.
There's another one. Four cats so far. Boy, would he have been in clover, he'd see a cat. What did you say there?
Well, I guess I'm perfect.
Fire hydrant! That's what he said. That's the last time I'll go to a costume party dressed as a fire hydrant, what he said.
I thought first dressed as Doris Day, then I thought better, and then I wrote fire hydrant.
Fire hydrant. That's two for you. Okay. Now, Gene, this one's all yours. Listen carefully. Everyone plays. Steve said... Now, listen to this carefully now. Steve said, I am never, ever going back to Dr. Smith again.
No. Why not?
Well, you know how when you go to a doctor's office, he said, now, instead of hitting you on the knee with a little rubber hammer, you know the way they do that there, and you go, bing, whatever. He uses a sledgehammer. And he doesn't hit you on the knee. He hits you in the blank.
He hits you in the blank.
Yes.
Oh, there it is. Now, that's it. Now, you just take my advice. That's the answer.
He hits you. All right.
Now, that's all right, isn't it?
You brought up something very interesting when you asked that question. What is that? Right?
Oh, okay.
Right. Did you finish?
Yeah.
Yes, okay.
Gene is better than us.
Right. Right, sure.
Gene?
Yes. Yes, oh, that'll be lovely. All right, Brett, we're all set. Now we come to Gene Harrison. I see all lights are going there. Steve said, now listen to him. I am never going back to Dr. Smith again. Instead of hitting on the knee with a little rubber hammer, he uses a sledgehammer. And he doesn't hit you in the knee. He hits you in the blank.
In the or on the? In the.
Well, it says in the. Does that make a difference?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Well, we said in the to them, so
okay.
We say in the
mouth.
In the mouth. Bang. Okay. He hits you in the mouth. Hey, you know, it hadn't occurred to me until she asked that in the and on the really would maybe create two different responses. On the nose or on the head. In the nose, right. In the head. You wouldn't say that, would you? What would you say, Dick?
I said in the groin.
In the groin, yes. I hesitate to think of the terrible pain. Brett, what do you say?
I say, are you from the North Country or are you just plain Scotch?
No.
Where are you from?
It's from the North Country.
Yes.
Bolton.
Oh, would I ever disappoint anybody who was from the North Country? You bet your old-fashioned bippy I wouldn't. I said in your old mouthies.
In the mouthies, so that matches her. That's one for her. Okay. He doesn't hit you in the knee, he hits you
I said in the stomach.
In the stomach, that would hurt too. Okay. Yes, it does make a difference in the and on the, doesn't it, Jody?
Yes, unfortunately.
What did you say?
Embarrassingly, so I said derriere. In the
that would hurt too much. Oh, I guess with a sledgehammer, that would hurt a lot there.
Well, what we call over, Al Smarto.
Yes.
Son of derriere.
Oh, son of derriere. Two in a row. You hit him four times there. What do you say? Oh, speaking of... Oh, hello, Fanny. He doesn't hit you in the knee. He hits you in the mouth.
I was terribly influenced by in the.
Yes.
And I wrote on the head. I'm sorry.
In the on the head.
Yeah.
He hits you in the head. So here we are at the end of round one, and the score is 2-1 in favor of Craig. Round two coming up in a moment or so, but right now, pay attention to this. All right, here we go again. End of round one. Round two coming up. Now, Craig Aarons, you're in the lead. We ask you to make a selection. Do you want A or B?
I think I'll take A this time.
A this time. Two people do not play. Richard does not play. Fanny does not play.
That's not true.
Oh, really? Don't tell all. We're on television all over America. Kathy said, my new boyfriend is no fun. Last night we went to a drive-in movie. All he wanted to do was blank. No fun at all. That's right, all he wanted to do was blame. Right, got the idea there. Splendid. All right.
We're all set. Darling.
Craig. Kathy said, my new boyfriend is no fun. Last night, we went to a drive-in movie. All he wanted to do was...
watch the movie.
Watch the movie. All right.
Well, I now, don't understand that.
What's that?
I don't understand. Isn't that why you go to a drive-in movie?
Well, not when you go with a pretty girl and you're sitting
there... Are you supposed to go with a girl?
Yes.
Well, Dick, that's ridiculous.
Why do we keep doing it, then?
We've been going now for 2 years together. I never could understand why people love drive-in movies.
Yeah, but you've seen a lot of pictures, though, haven't you?
Horrible.
Yeah.
Oh, well, we'll go with a girl next
I
time.
Think you're right.
What do you say to that?
I'm afraid that I dated myself, and I said Nick.
Really? Oh, it's upside. Your neck is upside down. There it is.
So the story of my life.
Well, now, wait a minute. Oh, I think you misunderstood the question because I'll give it to you.
You can swing that ragtime, ducks.
We went to a drive-in. You see, he's no fun at all. We went to a drive-in movie. All he wanted to do was neck.
Yes. Well, they didn't like each other, you see.
Oh, I see. Oh, well, that
you see?
Casts a whole new light on it, of course. Yes. You never neck in the movies?
Never. Once in a while, we...
Yeah. Well, hold on.
Well, that's another
whole
story,
as far as you go. What do you say?
You know what we say.
What?
The man who called it necking was a poor judge of distance.
That's true.
No, you know how much I draw on... Thanks, hon. You know how much I draw on my own personal experience.
That's
with
right.
Soldiers, sailors, Marines, all
right.
That stuff. All he wanted to do was watch the film.
Watch the film.
Okay, Dave. Charles, what do you say about this?
I feel terrible. I didn't say watch the film.
What did you say, dear?
Because I didn't have enough money to come up with that kind of cultivated education to say film.
What did you say?
I said watch the movie.
That's what you said. Same thing with the match of Craigie's up to four. All right, Jody Donovan. Kathy said my new boyfriend is no fun. Last night we went to a drive-in movie. All he wanted to do was...
watch.
Watch? Oh, really? That's as far as you go, right?
Watching Dick and
Richard. Watching Dick and Richard, yes. And so that's the end of that, and everybody's responded, and he's up to five, and now we come to Gene Harrison. Now, my dear, you must match four of our celebrities to stay in the game. However, if you match five, you win the game.
Mm-hmm.
You ready for this? One person does not play, that's Brett. You lay out. The rest of you respond to this, if you would, please. I have here in my very hand a letter to dear Abby.
Abby?
Yes.
Dear
it reads as follows.
Yes.
Abby's marriage is on the rocks.
Well, you'll see. It'll be signed. So you'll understand.
You're not supposed to read other people's mail.
Well, I'm going to read this one.
I'm just killing a little time here. 3 minutes.
Dear Abby.
Well, that would figure if it was to Abby.
That's right.
Wouldn't say dear friend.
No, it wouldn't say dear friend, would it?
No.
It says, dear Abby, my husband thinks he's a cow. What should I do? What should I do? Signed, Cow's Wife. Then you see, dear Abby, she wrote back.
She wrote
said,
back.
Dear Cow's Wife.
I do it every time.
She said, dear Cow's Wife, blank him.
Aha.
Okay, you idiot. I'm just going to play this.
Give it to him. Okay, Charles, did you put in the slot? You haven't even written yet anything, Charles. Okay, now he's ready to come over here to Gene Harrison. The letter to, do you know Dear Abby is? Have you been in this country long enough to pick up a newspaper and see Dear Abby's column? You have indeed. All right, the letter says, Dear Abby, my husband thinks he's a cow. What should I do? Signed, Cow's Wife. Dear Cow's Wife, she responded, you see. Blank him.
Don't be afraid, dear.
Speak up, my dear, I can't hear you.
Repeat it one more time.
Oh, all right, repeat it one more time. Dear Abby, my husband thinks he's a cow. What should I do? Signed, Cow's Wife. Dear Cow's Wife, blank him.
Milk him.
Milk him. All right. Now, she said, milk him.
Well, oddly enough, so did I.
Indeed. That's one for Gene Harrison. Score is 5-2 now. Favor of Craig. Brett doesn't play. Charles.
But she's still lovely to look at anyway. Yes. I said also milk him.
You said also milk him. The colonel said milk him. All right, Jody, honey, what did you say?
I also said milk.
You also said that. Score is now 5-4 in favor of Craig. Gene is creeping up on
if
Craig.
If she swung him around a little first,
right.
She'd get half and half. Milk him.
Milk him. Tie score. Now, if she milks him one more time, the game is over and Gene wins. At this moment, it's a tie. Do we break the tie or not?
Hi, hon.
Hello, honey.
I think this is an utter ridiculous question. I said milk.
Milk wins the game. Come on down. Congratulations. Okay. Now, you stand by there for a moment or so. Stand right there on the adhesive tape. Okay? You can look at your public out there. And we're going to say goodbye to Craig Aarons. We've got some guests, some gifts for you. Together with our thanks for being with us on Match Game PM. So long, Craig. While we're spinning him off, we'll spin this message for you. How do you feel? Okay, here we are with Gene Harrison, who's won this game. Jeannie, it's time now for the Big Money Super Match, where you can win over $10,000. Now, to do that, we have two audience matches for you, and whatever you win in these audience matches, you'll have a chance to multiply by 10. We're going to, you know, you did very well with the celebrities. Now we're going to see how your ESP works with a whole big group of people who were here recently. We polled them, and we got their best response to this. Wind blank. Now, that audience, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Now, if you match the answer they gave second most frequently, you get $250. And the third most frequently given response, if you match it, it nets you $100. Three celebrities are permitted to help. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Wind in the Willows.
Wind in the Willows.
A lovely child's book that no one's obviously ever read.
Yes, Graham Greene. Right?
Yeah.
Marvelous book.
And he was English, too.
Yes.
Fanny.
Windex!
Windex.
No, it's just, is it one word or is it two words?
You want to say Windex?
No.
That's your answer. That's No, we have to count your first response.
Okay.
Windex is what it is. All right.
Brett.
What about windmill?
Windmill. So those are for you. Windmill, Windex, and Wind in the Willows. Do you want to choose one of those or give us one of your own?
Yeah, I loved Richard's, but I think I like Brett's better.
You go with Brett. All right.
I hope you're right, my
She's
darling.
Apologizing for not choosing
I
yours.
I just want her to win.
All right, we all want her to win. Windmill is what she's looking for.
Oh, I hope.
And let's find out how her ESP works now. We are looking for a windmill. Would you please reveal the $100 response? Wind song.
Oh, I already hate it. They were a funny group, I can tell.
No, that's not a bad answer, wind song. She's looking for windmill. Let's find out if windmill is under the $250 response. Windstorm.
Oh, my Lord. I told
it's
you
very
they were
perplexing
funny
to
group.
Me. We don't have any of the answers that any of our celebrities suggested so far.
No.
Last chance for windmill. Please be under the $500 response. Yes, it is. Okay. All right. Now, Gene, you've won $500, which means that the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now we're going to see how much more you can win with our second audience match. Here we go. Reveal it, Earl. Blank stiff. Remember $5, $250, and $100, and now it's time to call on celebrities.
Okay, Richard.
What you are, a lucky stiff.
A lucky stiff. There's one.
Fanny.
Oh, dead stiff.
Dead stiff. Okay.
And I'll try Jody.
Jody, what do you say?
Scared stiff.
Scared stiff. So there they are, scared stiff, dead stiff, and lucky stiff.
Okay, I'll go with Jody's because I'm scared stiff.
All right, scared stiff is what she wants. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 response? Lucky stiff.
Worth every penny.
That's right. That's the one that Richard gave you. That may be a good omen. Let's see if it's under the $250 response. Frozen stiff.
Oh, uh-oh. It's got to be.
All right. Last chance for scared stiff. Here is the $500 response. Scared! Yeah! Oh, boy! Very good, Gene Harrison. And you've won another $500. We multiply that by 10, gives you another $5,000. We add that to the previous $5,000 you won. That gives you a pot of $10,000 to shoot for. Now, to To collect that amount of money, you must match one celebrity head-to-head. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay, Richard, you get ready to write. She's going to face me. Now, you're going to concentrate real hard now. Think carefully. Get your ESP going with Richard. Here it is. Blank Hamilton. Blank Hamilton. Now, he's finished. Now you concentrate real hard and think of an answer which you think will match Richard's blank Hamilton.
Oh, it's got to be George Hamilton.
What makes you say that?
Oh, that's the only thing I thought of, Gene.
All right. Well, she says that ESP will work in this case. Richard, she says George Hamilton will match you for $10,000. What do you say?
You're English, and I thought Lord Nelson. Who did he marry?
Oh.
Lady Hamilton. Her middle name was George.
Join us next week for Match Game PM. Gene Evernier, goodbye.
Some contestants will receive Brown Fetters, a rotary powered pickup, a powerful room air conditioner, so lightweight you want to take it everywhere you go. And from across.